Sometimes you have to wonder who the more powerful being is, God or Satan. Up here in Appalachia, there's a church just about every few miles. The folks inside would tell you that by believing in Christ and letting go of your earthly desires, you may one day enter the kingdom of heaven, the paradise ruled by the Lord Himself. But why is it that earthly desires are seen as something we should ignore? After all, we do live on earth, don't we? So, what's wrong with living in accordance with the only place we know? Maybe earth is ruled by the devil. A fellow that lives right in the eyes of the Lord might be comforted by the promise of everlasting life in heaven. But what of those who live according to the will of Satan? What are they promised? I do not have the answers to these questions. However, what I discovered last night has left me sure that there are people on this mountain who do. The Mundis once again came down the road an hour past midnight. I watched out the window as they passed my house without incident, three men, two women, and the old lady. My goal for the night was to follow them and find out what exactly it is that they've been doing. Gun clipped to my waist, I set out into the night behind them. I stayed back a great ways so as to not take any chances of spooking them. For this reason, I'd brought some binoculars with me as well. The Mundis walked like a group possessed. There was no chatting. No pointing. No looking up at the stars or for the hooting owls. No concern about bears or the rustling noises the woods make at night. They just kept walking, and then towards the end of the road where the ground begins to level out, they stepped into the woods. I was about 100 yards behind them. The way I saw it, my options were to either give up and go home or hasten my pace a bit and follow them into the woods. I chose the latter. Going into Appalachian woods at night can be risky for many reasons. Dangerous wildlife is an obvious one, but I bet you all ain't too familiar with shiners. Hillbillies hiding amongst the trees, producing illegal moonshine. Them fellas get real paranoid sometimes. I stepped to the forest line and listened for the crunch of leaves. I could hear the Mundis moving, but the forest was too thick to see through. They don't use any flashlights or lanterns, so any shadows they cross through keeps them hidden. I decided to step into the woods and follow the noise. I had to walk as slowly and carefully as possible, otherwise I couldn't hear them over my own movement. After several minutes of sneaking through the woods, my heart jumped as a commotion stirred directly in front of me. The rustling of the leaves was followed by a quick patter away. A rabbit. I relaxed at the realization and then immediately tensed back up when I noticed that the Mundis had stopped moving. I held my breath and knelt down. My heart was racing. Somebody moved. Slowly, as if sneaking up on prey. I unholstered my pistol and unlocked the safety. There was movement in front of me, but as I leaned forward to get a better look at what appeared to be a human figure, there was sudden motion to my left. Then immediately following that, more movement, but this time to my right. I began to slowly back up, but then I stopped dead in my tracks. There was someone lurking behind me. I was surrounded. I began to panic. The only thing I felt I could do was run away, gun blazing. I readied myself, and then something strange happened. I heard the movement of a group from the same spot the Mundis had been prior to the rabbit incident. They were moving away from me. So who had me surrounded? I waited a moment for any indication that I was still surrounded, but heard nothing except the fading footsteps of the Mundis. Could it have been my imagination? I could see that the woods opened up to a road ahead. The moonlight revealed that the Mundis were no longer obscured by the trees. I stayed back and watched as they crossed the road and headed down a long driveway towards a dark, single-story home. I sat back at the forest line and lifted the binoculars to my eyes. I recognized the house as the one the Keller family lives in. They're a friendly couple with three young kids. I see them in town every now and then, and the occasional barbecue. I couldn't stand the thought of something happening to them and their boys. I almost fired off a shot, as a warning, but then I saw Mr. and Mrs. Keller standing on their porch, waiting for the Mundis. The image of the two families standing together was baffling at first. They were polar opposites. But as the Mundi stepped to them, the killers fell to their knees and bowed, as if they were worshipping those Inbreds. The old lady stepped to the front of the pack, while the killers remained, bowing. She must have said something, because they both sat up simultaneously to look at her. Then the old lady motioned towards the house and the five younger Mundis entered. The old lady and the killers remained outside. Suddenly, the Keller children began screaming. They were crying, begging. Out the front door came the Mundis, dragging the terrified children. The children spotted their parents, and pleaded for them to help. The parents did nothing but fall to their knees once again and bow to the old lady. The three male Mundis gripped the children, carried them like luggage. The kids kicked and flailed, one even appeared to bite the leg of his captor, all to no effect. I'd seen enough. I stood and fired a series of shots into the air. "Let them go," I yelled. The Mundis stopped and looked at me, and then once again, the old lady let out the familiar soul-piercing scream. The male Mundis dropped the children and charged me, but the females scooped the Keller boys right back up. Through my peripheral I saw one of the women sprinting away at what I can best describe as an Olympian speed while holding two children, the second sister not far behind with the other child. These were not babies they were holding, these were grade school children, and the women were running as if them boys weighed nothing. I could hear the fading echo of the bellowing children as they were carried off into the night. The Mundi brothers were nearly on me, as I fired shot after shot. The moment was too chaotic for me to point and aim. I couldn't tell if I was hitting them, as I was both running away and shooting simultaneously. Then, as if sent by God himself, headlights appeared around the bend. They illuminated the Mundis, who promptly scattered and disappeared into the woods. I listened as the crunch of the leaves grew more distant beneath their rapidly moving feet. The vehicle stopped, and I took the moment to look towards the Keller house. The old lady was gone, but there, Keller couple still remained. They just stood there watching me. The door of the stopped vehicle flew open. "Get in," yelled the driver. I recognized his voice. It was my dad. I jumped into his truck and immediately began telling him that the Keller boys had been kidnapped by the Mundis, and that we needed to call the police. He sped off towards home, not stopping to give the killers an ounce of acknowledgement. Dad's hands were tight around the steering wheel. Without looking at me, he spoke, "It's time you know the truth about the Mundis."